Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. Let's take a look at what's in store today.
So today we're going to be looking at the Winds of Fortune event. Now this just landed in game this morning and you can see it says here the Winds of Fortune blow your way, granting you extra rewards on your adventure. Now this is available from today until the 8th of October at 3 a.m. So be sure to take part in this event. During the Winds of Fortune event, earn doubled rewards while playing. Return to this page to claim the following rewards. So you've got experience, gold and battle pass points as well. Here's the activities that you can do to gain the points. It shows you exactly what it will give you double of. So you've got things like Bestiary, Helichree, Challenge Rift, Bounties, Elder Rifts, Fishing, Dungeons, Purge the Depths, Ereban, Abyssal Verge, Accursed Towers, Wild Zone Kills, Hidden Lairs. And with this, you have the double gems dropping in things like Abyssal Verge and Ereban, so this makes it much easier to hit your weekly cap. Now myself and my friend Ben Kai, we did Abyssal Verge this morning and it took us only 45 minutes to cap our gems, and we did have some small breaks in between. So I'm just going to show you now exactly what this looks like and what you actually gain from completing it. Now, neither of us had actually farmed our weekly gems until this point. We decided to wait for this event to launch in game so that it would be a lot quicker to do. Obviously, if you farm your weekly gems, whether you're doing Lairs, Ereban, or Abyssal Verge, it can take quite a long time to cap them. So waiting for this event just made sense, a much easier way of actually gaining your weekly gems. And like I said, we managed to do this all within 45 minutes. So what we're aiming for here is a score of at least 2,000 so that we can get the maximum gems from this run. And what we've done as well is split up like I've shown in Abyssal Verge before. So when you run Verge, it just seems much easier to gain that high score if you split up and manage to keep your kill streaks going as well. So as you can see, I'm kind of just going through and killing as much as possible. I find this works much better than just focusing on the elite mobs that you see. Because quite a few people run it and just focus on elites and nothing else. But actually, if you just go through and try and kill everything, it just seems to give you a much higher score anyway. So yeah, we're going to complete this run of Verge and then look at the end to see all the rewards we gain from completing it with the double gems active. Now, if you're wondering about build here, I'm using my basic farming build, which I've shared many times before. So the video for this is up on my page and I'll link it in the comments so that you can see. But this is the build that I generally use for Abyssal Verge because it just seems to work really nicely. It gives you a lot of speed to run away from the terror, as you can see. So yeah, this is the build that I always use for running this and also for running Ereban as well. Now I'm pretty sure I've mentioned it in my Abyssal Verge run videos before, but the best time to kill the boss in this mode is after you've reached just over 1,800 points, because killing the boss will actually take you to that 2,000 points and give you the maximum gem drop as well. So if you're using Verge to farm gems, make sure that you get that higher score or as high a score as possible before actually taking the boss down, which is what myself and Ben Kai are doing here. You can see he kind of came down the map further, and we're just trying to clear as many of these mobs as possible. I don't know if we're going to get enough. There doesn't seem to be enough mobs to actually complete that, because you can see we're both going to end up dying in the terror if we don't take the boss down now. So yeah, unfortunately sometimes you cannot hit that score, but you get about 200 points for killing the boss at the end. So you can see here we've got double gems anyway. Normally we would have earned 6 gems, I think it is, 3 of each type, and we earned double that. Now, I'm also going to show you a screenshot from one of the other runs that we did where we did actually get the full gems. So you can see here, I actually had 14 gems here because it was my last run that we needed to cap. So although we hit the score, that was literally the maximum gems that I could gain from that last run. So that is it from me today. I hope you found this video helpful. If you haven't farmed your gems yet, definitely do it while this event is active. Make sure you try and get it done at the beginning of the week. And obviously, Verge or Ereban are the fastest ways to gain your weekly gems now as well. So that's it from me today. I hope you have a great one and I'll see you next time.